I'm not going to do a big introduction because everyone knows about you, but I'm going to request you to sing now. Anything. Something that's unique, a collaboration, because that's what you're known for.
I will sing a piece of music that I did with Dominique Vela. I sang it for the memorial to Srimati Indira Gandhi last October when...
Shabd Brahmamayi Characharamayi Vangmayi Shri Shabd Brahmamayi Characharamayi Madre, Madre, Madre Omni Potente.
What a beautiful... I mean, what a beautiful coming together of two female principals.
Yeah,
isn't it?
Absolutely.
It's stunning,
it's really.
And that's Latin,
beautiful.
Is that Latin?
That is archaic Italian.
Wow. And your pronunciation sounds impeccable. I wouldn't know anyway, but it just sounds fabulous. So does someone sing that for you and you learn from somebody? Or
yeah,
how do you do
because
these
I work
things?
With so many international artists. Dominique Vela, who is a master of Gregorian chant, he sings this song in the concert and I sing the Shabd Brahmamayi section.
Oh, so you don't
so
sing
I don't
this.
Sing the
oh,
Italian part in when we are in a Pakka concert.
Okay.
But yes, when we are singing in private or sometimes when we finish a song, I come together with him on some of the Italian or the German parts just to show that I'm trying to sing this. And he sings, for example, the song Kantamam in Tamil with me. Because unless you make that extra effort to communicate and to learn somebody's language and music, it doesn't show that willingness, to yourself and the audience. So we try to...
But you've never performed these in India, right? No.
Dominique and I have done a series of concerts supported by the French embassy.
But not in Chennai.
In Chennai, yes. We performed at the Museum Theatre, but this was a while ago.
Oh, I must have been a toddler.
Yeah.
So what was the reaction now? I mean, you're known as a classical singer. When you do a collaboration like this, how did they react?
Yeah, I must say again, hats off to the Chennai audience because I was, at every city you had your own, thoughts as to how they would receive it. And of course I had thoughts about Chennai, but I should say, in the whole series of 8 concerts in 8 cities, the Chennai one was the most applauded, most acknowledged and acclaimed concert. And that's a tribute to the open-mindedness of the Chennai audience.
So it's not true then at all that we're a city of traditionalists. It's not
no,
true.
No, I think
I know not anymore, because now we're very open-minded, but say 10, 15 years ago.
I think we were always open-minded. Look at the way we have embraced and listened to Hindustani music or any other kind of music or theater. I mean, we just welcome any creative newness in experience.
So how did you get introduced to Dominique Bellart?
I was performing at the Théâtre de la Ville in Paris. As you know, it's the dream
So Arunaji, you have a very unconventional Carnatic music voice, you know, whatever that means, but you know what I mean. When he comes, we go together to buy him DVDs. I have a man who has all kinds of European cinema.
Are you Yanak Chola?
Sure. Arunaji, you have a very unconventional voice for a Carnatic musician, right? So what did you feel when you were growing up and when you were learning music as a youngster?
Yeah, I suppose it takes everyone a while to accept, understand what they are and to feel comfortable with it. So I did take time to know that mine is a voice with a lot of body.
Yeah, it kind of shakes the core of one's own being when they listen to you.
So it takes some understanding of it to take it, carry it with me, you know, when I'm going down or in the middle range or the higher range. It takes some knowledge to move around with that voice. But once I knew that, I was very comfortable, and then I haven't looked back since then.
It is an asset, really. It is, you know. So is that why you went to Germany? You went for voice training lessons?
Yeah, the voice training happened as a coincidence. But let's say I had always been questioning that voice training aspect in my mind, you know. It was a search.
So now voice training is different from your regular music classes, right? Like part classes that we go to.
Yeah.
Are you saying that voice training does not happen there?
It does. It does. Yeah. Whenever you sing, you are training your voice also.
Okay.
But then when you go to somebody who is a specialist in voice training, they give you some more insights into certain things that you can do.
Like breath control.
Yeah. Most of it is breath. Because the whole sound emanates. That's why they call it as Nada Yoga.
And what about overuse of the voice? That's another thing that you need to watch out for.
Yeah, that should not be done. My guru Brindamma always told me, don't sing for hours and hours together. So I would sing for certain number of hours, and the rest of the time she would make me sit and do the mantra sthayi. That is, you sing in a very low octave and to yourself. You don't sing loudly, and then you practice all the moves in that low you shouldn't whisper either, but in a low voice. And then when you're ready with your practice, then you actually sing it.
So you were saying that it's all in the mind, you're practicing in the
mind. It's the mind. Anything they say that when you map it out in your mind and then actually you do it, it just works so well.
Another thing I want to ask you is how you manage your career as a musician, because gone are the days when, you know, there were patrons, you could just sing for God, concentrate on your own sadhana. Today you're out there in the marketplace because there are so many competitors, so many musicians, everyone doing something new, some new collaboration. So how do you manage this aspect? Does it stress you out?
No, I mean, I think I remember something that my dad told me, and I try to remember that always. He said, you pursue excellence and success will follow on its own. You know, and that really works. No matter how much competition there is or whatever, all those things that you mentioned, it really works when you work on yourself, improving yourself day after day, month after month, and trying to focus on that. Things just follow suit. You don't have to really worry about it too much.
And how supportive has your family been? I know that your mother was a singer, but she wasn't a professional singer, was she, Mom?
Yeah, she did a few concerts, but she was more into teaching, and she was a disciple of Alathur brothers. She was a great inspiration.
And now your husband?
Oh, he loves music. He loves to listen.
Nobody in his family is a musician?
No, they're not musicians, which is, they are great listeners.
And your daughters?
they also are great listeners. They are not into music, but they are my inspirations.
So you never got them to learn music even? Did they even
They learned for fun. They did do it as a hobby.
Is that something you feel bad about, that they didn't pursue it?
No, I don't. I think each individual is cut out for something and you follow your course in life.
But right now, Arunaji and I are very excited about our upcoming concert for NDTV Hindu, a collaboration, a unique Jugalbandi with Padmashri U. Srinivas, the mandolin maestro. I think we should show them a little bit of what we have in store for you. The concert is on the 7th of September at Sir Mutta Venkata Subba Rao Hall.